Welcome to Greenply's state-of-the-art manufacturing facility for Green PanelMax MDF. Incorporating cutting-edge European technology, Green PanelMax MDF undergoes careful manufacturing processes and stringent quality tests to make it a high-performance, world-class product. The process for manufacturing Green PanelMax MDF starts with a careful selection of renewable plantation eucalyptus or poplar logs to ensure that only suitable logs reach the MDF site for processing. On arrival at the factory, trucks carrying the logs are weighed and timber quality checked. These are then sent to the unloading stations where three fixed rotating log cranes efficiently unload the logs onto a chain conveyor. The logs then travel over separating rollers which remove any foreign materials like stones and sand particles. They are further scanned by a metal detector to protect downstream equipment as they travel to the chipper. The logs are then fed to a drum chipper which produces wood chips of the highest quality for the manufacture of MDF. These chips are then further conveyed and passed under a magnet for removal of any metal presence before reaching the chip storage area for stocking. The chip storage area has three sections. High quality chips for use as raw material are stored in two sections, while the third section receives the rejected waste chips as well as other purchased chips used for fuel. Stored chips are reclaimed for the refining process by using a moving floor system, which feeds these chips to a metering conveyor on demand. Before reaching the refiner, the chips are screened by a Brook screen to remove unsuitable size chips and once again scanned for metal detection. Contaminated and waste chips are removed and reclaimed by the moving floor system for sending to the first of its kind multi-fuel in-house energy plant, where these are used to generate thermal energy in the form of steam, flue gas and thermal oil for the ongoing manufacturing process. Meanwhile, appropriate quality chips simultaneously arrive at the latest generation refiner for the refining process, which starts with the chips entering a pre-steaming bin where steam channelized from the in-house energy plant is injected into the bin under atmospheric pressure to soften and equalize the moisture level in the chips. Chips are then discharged into a plug screw, where they are compressed and the water is removed along with unnecessary linen and natural oils present in the timber. The plug screw then transports the chips to a digester, also known as the preheater. The preheater cooks the wood chips under high steam pressure for approximately 3 to 6 minutes, which quickly increases the chip's temperature and softens the natural resin that bonds the wood fiber together. Softened chips are fed into the main housing using a ribbon feed screw. Depending upon the requirement, the amount of chips being fed is controlled by regulating the speed of the feed screw. Within the feed screw, molten high-quality paraffin wax is injected for coating the chips, which gives the final product its water-resistance properties. The chips are then forced between a pair of grinding discs called the stator and the rotor disc. These plates separate the chips into individual wood fibers. The quality of the fiber produced here is critical to the quality of the final product. Resins and additives are then added in the blow line, which transport the fibers to the dryer. Meanwhile, flue gas generated at the in-house energy plant is transported through a pipe into a two-stage dryer system. Moisture-laden, resin-coated fiber is transported through the blow line into the two cyclones, where, through a vortex motion, wood fiber is separated from the moisture-laden air in the first stage of the drying process. Fiber exiting at the bottom of the cyclone then enters a second stage drying process, where the moisture of the fiber is measured to accurately control the dryer temperature. Dried fiber enters an air grading system called the Z sifter to remove large and unwanted fibers as well as glue lumps that would be detrimental to the product quality and downstream machinery. From the air grader, the fiber is blown into the forming fiber bin, which enables the operator to maintain a buffer quantity for providing a constant flow of fiber to the mat forming station. The mat forming station spreads the fiber onto a conveyor, forming a continuous fiber matrix according to the desired thickness of the final product. The spreading controls of the forming station use a scalper system to achieve a critical optimum cross-panel mat density. The mat is then measured for mat density as well as for mat moisture to ensure accurate forming of the mat. The mat form is then pre-pressed to remove air out of the fiber mattress and provide pre-compression. Mat width is trimmed and travels under a metal detection device while the mat forming is constantly monitored. Any deviation from the stringent in-house specifications results in the mat being rejected before it enters the continuous press system. This is done to prevent any out-of-the-specification product reaching the marketplace. The approved mat formed then enters the hot continuous Diefenbacher press. The press is heated using thermal oil from the energy plant to elevate the resin-coated fiber to its reaction temperature and to ensure bonding of the fibers. As it travels along the length of the press, the mat is compressed under accurately controlled high pressure for ensuring the precise surface, core density and thickness along and across the mat. The continuous board exiting the Diefenbacher press is cut into the master board length and the thickness, weight and internal structure are measured in real time. This enables the operator to fine-tune the quality and pressing process, and any panel found outside the quality specifications is removed and rejected. Approved quality master boards are then cooled in a cooler for some time and then taken to an intermediate storage, where they are stored to recover to natural atmospheric conditions for 48 to 72 hours for sanding and finishing. A fully automated two-dimensional storage system called Looky facilitates a user-friendly storage and inventory management. Using an automated trolley and overhead wagon, the Luki stacks raw MDF panels in the storage for resin curing, further testing and analysis. Green Panel Max MDF boards are sent to a state-of-the-art laboratory for through panel density profiling and a range of tests including the internal bond test, water absorption and swelling test, linear expansion and thickness test, modulus of elasticity and modulus of rupture test, screw withdrawal strength test and cyclic test. The Luki also delivers the correct stack for further process of sanding and sizing in finish sizes and thickness to an 8 feet sanding machine with 8 heads. The sander simultaneously sands the top and bottom surfaces of the boards to create a super fine surface finish. The station operator removes any additional poor quality and visually defective boards. Once sanded, the premium raw boards enter the Gibbon line cut to size sawing system to be cut in the final Green Panel Max range and sizes. The final panels are then graded, stacked and stored to be dispatched to our customers. Finally, high quality, world-class Green Panel Max MDF boards are loaded on trucks for deliveries across India.